Today, I am going to discuss about components of internal combustion engine. Sometimes it is called as parts of the IC engine. And this is the image of the IC engine, and this one is the animation of the IC engine. So today we are going to discuss the different components of this IC engine. So welcome to my YouTube channel, Mechanical Engineering Management. Like, share, and subscribe. So this is the cut section of the IC engine. And these are the different parts that we are going to discuss one by one. So let's start from the first part of the IC engine, valves. So here you can see these are actually the valves, and here also you can see valves. So minimum two valves per cylinder. So here you can see per cylinder two valves are there. One is the inlet valve and another one is the outlet valve. Sometimes it is called as the exhaust valve and inlet valve. So exhaust valve is used to exhaust gases from the combustion chamber. Diameter is smaller than intake valve. So keep in mind, this is the important point. Diameter of the exhaust valve is smaller than intake valve. Intake valve is used to enter air or air fuel mixture to combustion chamber. And here you can understand diameter is larger than the exhaust valve. So keep in mind, the diameter of the intake valve is always larger than the diameter of the exhaust valve. Now next part, valve springs. So here you can see valve springs, and here also you can see valve spring. And this is the animation. Here you can see the spring that is provided. So particularly the function of this valve spring is written over here. The valve springs keep the valves closed condition. That's why it is called as return spring. Here you can see. Next, camshaft. So here you can see this one is the camshaft, and here this is the animation camshaft on which cams are mounted. The main function of the camshaft is to open and close the valves at the appropriate time. So here you can see this is the intake valve and exhaust valve, and that is operated by these cams that is mounted on the camshaft. The cam is operated by means of gear arrangement driven by the flywheel. So here you can see this camshaft is operated by means of gear arrangement and timing belt, and that is driven by means of flywheel. Next, the cam converts rotary motion into linear motion that operates the rocker arm. So here you can see this one is the rocker arm. So the cam that is provided over here converts the rotary motion of the camshaft into linear motion that you can see over here, and that operates this rocker arm. The motion of the rocker arm operates the valves. One more image of the camshaft. So here you can see the cams are provided on the camshaft. Now next part, spark plug. So this is the image of the spark plug, and this is also the image of the spark plug, and this is the figure to understand the location of the spark plug. This portion is zoom over here, and here you can see the spark is there. That's why it is called as spark plug. So the spark plug is used to ignite the air fuel mixture. Electrical energy is transmitted through the spark plug, jumping the gap in the plug's firing end if the voltage supplied to the plug is high enough. So if you supply high voltage to the spark plug, and so that in the gap the spark is produced, and due to that the air fuel mixture is ignited. This electrical spark ignites the gasoline, or sometimes it is called as air fuel mixture, in the combustion chamber. Now next part is piston, and here you can see the piston that is surrounded by the piston ring. So here you can see the piston is connected by the connecting rod in the IC engine. And this is the location of the piston in the IC engine. Piston is the main part of the engine, its main function is to compress the charge and to transmit the gas force to the connecting rod during the power stroke. So here you can see, whatever it may be, the gas force that is exerted on the piston, that will be transmitted to the connecting rod during the power stroke. So we can say it is a movable part fitted into the cylinder which can receive and transmit the power, usually made of aluminium alloy, which has good heat conducting property and greater strength at higher temperature. Next one, more image of the piston. Now next part is cylinder head. So here you can see, this is the cylinder head. This is also cylinder head. The top end of the cylinder is covered by the cylinder head, over which inlet and exhaust valve, spark plug or injectors are mounted. Here you can see a copper or asbestos gasket is provided between the engine cylinder and cylinder head to make an airtight joint. Next part, engine block. So here you can see, this is the engine block and this is one more image of the engine block, so that you can understand exactly. Crankshaft with the piston that is mounted over here in this engine block. The purpose of the engine block is to support the components of the engine. Additionally, the engine block transfers heat from friction to the atmosphere and engine coolant. The material selected for the engine block is either gray cast iron or aluminium alloy. Next, connecting rod. This is the image of the connecting rod having two ends, big end and small end, and this portion is called a shank. And here you can see this connecting rod that is connected to the piston at the small end. The connecting rod connects the piston and the crankshaft. The piston is connected to the connecting rod by means of gudgeon pin. So here this is the gudgeon pin. It converts the reciprocating motion into a rotary motion. The upper end of the connecting rod is called as small head, and that is connected to the piston, and the lower end is called as the big end. Next, crankshaft. So this is the image of the crankshaft. Here you can see, this is the crankshaft. It converts the reciprocating motion of the piston into the rotary motion with the help of the connecting rod. The special steel alloys are used for the manufacturing of the crankshaft. It consists of eccentric portion called crank. So here you can see, this is the eccentric portion, is called as crank. This is one more image of the crankshaft. This is the eccentric portion that is called as the crank, and that is attached with the connecting rod. Now next part, piston ring. So here you can see piston ring. Topmost piston ring is compression ring and the lower one is called as oil ring. And here you can see, generally the compression spring are in two quantity. First one is the top compression spring and this one is the second compression spring. And the last one is the oil control ring. Piston rings are circumferential rings that are provided in the piston grooves. This groove are for the piston ring. The piston rings are not fully circular. Here you can see there is a clearance that is called as the ring gap between the two ends. This is provided because during the expansion stroke, piston rings expand due to the high temperature. Next, two types of rings, compression ring and oil ring. Compression ring is upper ring of the piston, here you can see, which provides airtight seal to prevent leakage of the burned gases into the lower portion. Oil ring is lower ring, which provides effective seal to prevent leakage of the oil into the engine cylinder. So generally, oil ring is used to prevent the leakage of oil, and that's why it is called as the oil ring. Whereas this top two ring is called as a compression ring because it provides airtight seal. Next, flywheel. So here you can see this is the flywheel, and this one is the animation of the IC engine, and here this one is the flywheel. It is a big wheel mounted on the crankshaft. This is the crankshaft, forming an inertial mass whose function is to maintain its speed constant. It is done by storing excess rotational energy during the power stroke and which is returned during the other remaining stroke. So you know that during the power stroke, the excessive rotational energy that is stored in the flywheel and that is returned back during the remaining three strokes. If you want to see more engineering videos, then subscribe my YouTube channel and go to playlist. So thanks my dear friends, press the like button to appreciate this video.